So have you ever wanted to create your own custom layouts for WordPress? Did you want to create something that's just a little bit unique, that might be different on different pages, but didn't know where to start, or didn't really want to get stuck into coding and messing about with the WordPress loop? Then I think this video is definitely going to be for you. So we're going to take a look at Astra, we're going to take a look at their hooks, and we're going to see why these are just so powerful. So let's just jump over into WordPress and take a look at how we can start creating our own custom layouts using Astra's hooks. Hi, I'm Paul C and this is WPTuts, where I show you how to create beautiful WordPress websites without all the technical jargon. If this is your first time on the channel, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell icon to be notified of our weekly new content as soon as it's added to the channel. So we're in the WordPress dashboard and we're ready to start creating our custom pages. One thing you need to know is that you need to have the commercial version of Astra and the commercial version of Elementor Pro to be able to really tap in and use this technique. Reason why is because the hooks plugin as part of the commercial pack gives you a whole range of really cool ways of being able to hook your content into the various different pages and different portions of the pages in WordPress. And Elementor Pro gives us the ability to be able to use the short codes for the templates that we create. Pulling all those things together makes creating custom pages incredibly easy. So assuming that you've got that, we can move on. If not, all the links are in the description below. You can click on those, follow through, go and purchase your copy of either Astra or Elementor Pro, and you'll be giving a little bit back to the channel by using our affiliate links. Doesn't cost you any more money, but it gives a little bit back to us. Anyway, assuming you've got those in place, we're going to move on and start creating things. So first thing we need to do is create our layout. And what we're going to do, if I jump over to my test pages, you can see that I'm looking at a blog page at the moment. So this is our normal blog listing for a particular category. So all the blog posts and everything you'd expect to see. A little bit of tweaking and customizing in Astra, but nothing special. This section at the top, though, is completely different. This is custom made. So this is using a template from Elementor Pro and hooking into the typical sort of WordPress loop. So how do we do all this? Well, first things first, we'd need to create that particular template. I'm going to assume that you can do this yourself. There's nothing specifically special about this. I've used a plugin to do it, but you don't need to. You can create any way you want. So what we've got is if we jump into Elementor, you can see my templates are the first option. Like I say, this is Elementor Pro only. We've then got a couple of different things at the top. We've got a couple of tabs that allow us to go and filter the different kinds of templates we've created, or we can just stay on this one and see all of them. So if I just open up the news blog header, you can see if I just jump into this page, it's a normal page, nothing special in there. If I jump into Elementor, you'll see that I've got everything laid out using the plugin that I'm going to be using for this. It's set to be full width in the template. Other than that, it's pretty straightforward. So this is our template that we're going to use. Jump back out of this. What we need to do is make sure we've got the short code for this particular section. And you can see there's our short code. So all I need to do is click, right click and copy that. I've now got that on my clipboard, so I'm now ready to move on and pull this in using the hooks. So what we need to do is go into Astra itself. So if I come up to appearance, you can see I've got Astra options. Click and load that in. There's all the different available pro modules. You can see I've got pretty much everything selected and enabled. What I need to do is come to the custom layouts. Click on settings and that'll load up the option for the custom layouts. So you can see we've got the news header template, which is what we're going to be using. And what we're going to do is, if we come in and edit this, you can see what's going on. There's our template. There's the little short code we copied. That's just pasted into the normal area that we put our content into. That's all we need to do. That will now reference that Elementor template. We don't need to use Elementor. We can just do it in there. What we're looking for, though, is this section underneath for the custom layout settings. Now, by default, you're going to see it'll be like this. Nothing will be active in there. So we can just go in and select. What we want to do is choose hooks. Once we do that, we open up all the hooks options, and now we can start tapping into the various different component pieces of our layout. If we expand the second option, that's saying the action. In other words, where do we want this content that we're pulling from this template into the particular page? Where do we want it? So you can see we've got things like the head section, the header, the content. Depending upon the different plugins you've got set up in here, you may have WooCommerce installed. You can see when you do that, there are various different places you can hook in on there as well. What we are looking for is to hook into the content area. So if we come up into the content, you can see we've got a range of different options. We want content top. So we click in there. You can see that now gives us the ability to go and do some things like set the priority. So if we've got various different things we're hooking into this area, we can specify the order they go into based upon their priority. We don't need to do that, we're only doing one item. I've set some spacing at the top so you can see to make sure that I've got this little gap in between the header and the sort of main content that we're pulling in, so we've got a nice gap there. You can control that yourself. You can do the same with the bottom as well. But where the power of this really comes in is the display on option. Now, if we expand that out, you can see we've got a ton of different options in there, broken down into their complexity and the different locations. So we've got the entire website. If we did this, then every single page, post page, archive page, everything would have that block placed at the top of it, at the top of the content area. What we want to do, though, is come down and be a little bit more refined on how we do this. And the very bottom one is where the real power of this starts to take effect. Specific target. If we select that, we can now go in and choose exactly where we want this template to be inserted. So you can see what I've got at the moment is to be in the news section, which is a category. So what I can do is I can come onto here and I can say, for example, I've got events set up as another category. So I can start typing events in. And you can see that will now pull up. You see we've got posts, events, category, events. Category means that it's the archive category section for a particular blog. So I've got two set up in here. I've got events and I've got news items. So you can easily hook it into that. I don't want that on there, so I'm going to leave that as it is. So it's just got the news item. So you can also set up add display rules, and you can set up exclusion rules. Sometimes you might want to display it on everything except for a particular category, for example. So we might want to put this on everything bar the news section. Well, we could add an exclusion rule in there and exclude news instead of having to go through and put everything in there. Kind of hope that kind of makes sense. You can also go through and restrict the user roles that can see this content. So you may say, for example, you only want subscribed users to be able to access it. So your general guest posts or guest public viewers sort of wouldn't see it. Well, you can simply come into this and you can see we've got the option for everybody logged in, logged out. And then also we can go down and filter it right the way down to exactly who can see it based upon their role. So really, really powerful. And like I say, I've covered this basically before, but I've never gone in with some of these new options, which is where you can control exactly what page it goes onto and you can filter that out. This for me is where the real power comes in. So let me just show you what I'm talking about. Let's just update this. So what I've done is I've created this section at the top, like I showed you. I've used a plugin to do this, to give me this sort of control of the layer, but you could use anything you want. You can drop anything you want in there. So what I've done is I've set this up to pull in only featured posts. So if I use the tag featured, these will be displayed in here. Doesn't matter what category they come from at all. So at the moment, I'm looking at the news category, as you can see at the top there. However, if I went into events, I won't see this section, even though it's a category. So if I come into events, you can see that section is not displayed. Only the posts are displayed in there. Whereas under news, that new section at the top comes in. So this is where we're hooking into specific sections of the site. If I go to the About Us page, for example, nothing on there. If I go to the shop section, not displayed on there. If I go to the blog general, not displayed on there. Only when I go into that particular section does it call up that new section we go into, that new template, and load it in through these dynamic hooks. And that's what I wanted to show you. This is where some real power comes in using the Astra hooks. And I hope some of the other themes out there that have hooks plugins will start to use this dynamic way of sort of pulling in your content where you want it to, because I think it's incredibly powerful. Well, that's what I wanted to show you. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please leave a comment down below saying how you could use it, what you've done with it, and share your experiences of using these hooks with the other users on this channel. If you found the video useful, a like rating would be really appreciated. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button, smash that bell icon to be notified every time we add new content. As always, until next time, take care.